Hello everyone, welcome to Glam Estates Radio Show, Wednesday, and we're here again. My name is Gregory Papoutsian, and with me today is Coco Selburn.
Hello everyone, I hope you're doing great this evening. It is a fabulous Southern California day, warm as ever, sunny,
very
bright.
Hot.
Maybe a little hotter than we like, but there you go. It is August, for crying out loud. And for those of you who download this podcast in January, you'll be enjoying that commentary on the weather.
Right. Thanks for tuning in. I hope everyone is doing great today and is as happy and excited as we are here.
We love it here. Are you kidding?
We do.
We love it. Uh-oh, there's no karaoke tonight?
No, we're not in a karaoke bar.
Dang it. Well, we could try. For those of you who want to get started on thinking about giving us a call, don't be shy.
Don't be shy at all.
Please, don't be shy. Although we do have someone who censors our phone calls now. If you're calling in and you're an obscene phone caller, you will get through right away. Just kidding.
What's our phone number?
It is 818-570-5085.
That's right.
What is it again? 818-570-5085.
And also, you can write us on Facebook, on our wall, leave us your comments, your opinions. What would you like the next show to be about?
What should I wear as a necklace?
The necklace is very important for Coco.
How glam can I be with my necklace? Please make a comment. Let me know.
We are very glam today.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to bring you a bow tie, I think, next time.
Oh, yeah. I have one, actually. I swear it next time.
Yes, that'll be fun. Absolutely.
How are you, Coco? How's your day? I haven't seen you at all today.
Oh, no, not at all, huh?
I haven't seen you from what time, 6:45 in the morning?
What property we started at in the morning? Drag each other around, like, listen, coffee, shh, just get in the car, shh.
Yeah. Thank God I had coffee before I come here. It started kicking in, and I'm like trembling here, but I'll be fine.
You'll be fine.
I hope. I better be.
Yes, exactly. No, we start our day very early. One of us will pick up the other from wherever part of town we have dropped the bag for the night and
but it's good.
Gotten off the computer. Like, okay, great.
Busy is good.
Absolutely. These are lovely problems to have.
Yep.
So one of the major things we were talking about recently was what? The overall...
We talked recently, the previous show. What did we talk about? Selling.
Us talk about something.
No, in the previous show, I just wanted to. We talked about sellers, and we were giving them selling tips. What to do?
Selling tips, how to get ready, how to get that house ready for market. What are you going to do? Get ready to get that sucker ready to go, and yourself ready to roll.
And of course, to get top dollar.
Please.
The most important.
Yes.
Most important.
How to get top dollar. Absolutely. My favorite word, absolutely.
And then after that, the whole week happened, and we had some.
It's been exciting times out at the ranch,
yes.
As we say. Yeah. Exciting times talking about negotiations, clients, and agents, and what happens behind the scenes. There's so many things that can happen, so many different variations. Out of all the... what seems like millions of transactions that happen out there, and probably billions, it seems like there's never two times that it's identical to the other.
Never.
Almost never. There's some different scenario because we're dealing with people.
Exactly.
So
different people, different transactions, different
circumstances,
problems.
Yes. They have a seller who has a need for this and a buyer who has a need for that. And maybe someone has a misinterpretation of the other and, text versus emails versus smoke signals, my favorite chime word of the week.
Messages in a bottle.
Oh, Messages in a bottle. Let's see if that one shows up somewhere this week.
Exactly.
Those of you who are listening will message. Know what we're talking about.
Message in a bottle. Message in a
message
bottle.
In a bottle. We're listening.
Yeah.
So we're talking about the overall process. And basically we've had, you know, more and more people who are interested in buying, and we're coming up with a seminar very soon. You will be seeing a seminar showing up where you can actually come and attend, get the basics from A to Z, or as we say, how do you say it in Greek, from where to where?
Από το Alpha μέχρι το Omega.
Από το
Alpha μέχρι το Omega. 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 You know Omega.
Omega, got Omega, it. But what was the two part? What?
From to.
Say it again. Apo.
From. To alpha. Alpha, the letter.
Right. No, we got it.
Yeah, mechri, apo. Mechri to apo. Apo to alpha. Say it.
What? Apo.
Say apo, a word apo? That you know. Say a Greek word that I've taught you and you know.
Malaka.
Don't say that word, Coco, please.
I was just kidding.
There's Greek people, you know, watching and listening to us right now.
I was just kidding.
I don't want you to call me and be like, why are you teaching me these bad words?
I'm like a 5-year-old. I repeat what
but
I'm
hearing. But it is international word. I mean, like.
No, I learned that way before I met you. That was the second word I ever learned in Greek.
Did you?
Well, long before you were ever available in the world of real estate, I had a friend who said it through every third word. And I thought it was a word that was kind of like, hello.
There's a few things that Greeks are known for, you know, feta, olives, and malaka.
Aw, well.
It depends how you use it. It can be a bad word or it cannot be a bad word. You know, if you're mad and you call the other, you know.
I certainly wouldn't mean it that way.
Yeah, I know. I know. I'm just saying.
I know. So there's a lot to know about the buying process and to understand the different chapters, so to speak, of where it is. So as we say, and say it again in Greek, what did you say? Apo,
alpha.
Apo to alpha.
Mechrito. Omega.
Omega.
There you go.
I'll never be able to get it twice,
you're
but there
you go. You're a great student of mine. You're a great student of mine.
As we say in Espanol, claro que sí.
How about we stay in the topic?
Why?
Just kidding.
Why should we do that? It's like a spinning wheel out here.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what?
What?
Let's get a spinning wheel. Let's get or a spinning wheel, and we just let it roll, and we just pick a subject.
Right. That's
a
good idea.
I'm ready for that, actually.
That's a good idea.
All right, everyone, let's vote on that. Who would like to see the spinning wheel of subjects?
Or we can have, like, somebody call.
Oh, my goodness.
And we spin the wheel, and whatever the topic, you know, wherever it goes, the topic, we pick this topic and we talk about
it. And they win a prize.
Okay.
Yeah. Cup of coffee.
Let's work on that. Don't be so large. You're always so large.
But I love coffee, so for me it's a huge
compliment. If it's from Starbucks, you are allowed.
Oh, we said a name brand. Now we've done two things for the day. We're on a roll, ladies and gentlemen. Woo!
Anyway.
All
right. So the last show was about
let's
sellers.
Let's sing a song and let's make it three.
Sing a song?
Let's play a song on there.
Oh, no, right, no. And then they kick us out, all together.
No more. No mas.
So yeah, the last week's show was about sellers and homeowners. So we thought this week we talk about buyers. Why not?
We love buyers, absolutely.
And the home buying process, and you know, give some tips to buyers.
There's so much to know. Where do you get started, Gregory? Where should someone start? Dime.
Speak
the
initial steps. Speak with a realtor. Call us at 562-537-2595.
So hey, that was brilliant.
So you can speak with a realtor and start your home buying process.
I love this. It's hysterical.
That's where everybody should start.
Absolutely. Yeah, you start with a professional, not somebody who's sort of doing it, you know, once in a blue moon.
Blue moon. I know this expression.
Uh-oh. That's going to show up too.
What? The blue moon?
Yeah. Message in a bottle.
Yeah.
And
once in a blue moon. Right.
That's the other one.
Let's see.
It's code words.
I'm curious to see.
Let's see if it shows up. Those of you who are listening.
Okay. So the first is
that's the word. Those are the words of the day. People
words
put them
the
on.
Day.
They
right.
Go ahead and put them on the website. If you put it on the website, hey, the first person who puts it on a website should win. Mm-hmm. What are they going to win?
2 cups of coffee.
I'm not sure. Hey. What else? Okay, 2 cups of coffee.
What else?
And a coffee pop. What are the coffee cake pops? Like the little cake on a stick? Again, from Starbucks. Uh-huh. I said it. Yeah, like they're little cakes on a, they're like a coffee lollipop. They're like a
oh,
cake pop.
Yeah.
Cake pop, that's what they call it.
Yeah.
I was thinking coffee again. So therefore, all cake products would therefore be coffee pops. Anyway.
Okay.
All right. So talk with a real estate consultant. You really want to talk to someone, tell them what you're looking for.
Real estate consultant.
Oh my gosh, for sure.
You said that.
Yeah.
No, you said talk to a real estate consultant.
Yeah, exactly.
Not to a real estate consultant, but to a real estate consultant.
Well.
I like that.
You know, just saying.
Hey, coffee helps, huh?
A little bit.
I should do it before.
I feel a little.
I should be drinking coffee before every show, I think. In other shows, I'm like that. And today, I'm like a little more pumped up. That's good.
I can imagine the comments we're going to get, the phone calls we're going to get after this.
The thing is that I stopped drinking coffee in January. I was drinking coffee for like 10 years, and I stopped drinking coffee in January. And they said that my life would be better.
I didn't.
But I don't see any difference in you know, towards my life getting better. I only see difference towards my life getting worse. But anyway.
Hey, I'm with you, man. I totally get it. My life is very good with coffee in it. And it's a legal substance. Doesn't cause me any adverse effects. I don't necessarily say that's true for everyone. But for us, it's working great. I got no problem for myself with it. But consult a physician to make sure it's okay for you.
Exactly. Anyway.
This is too fun. Where is all of our friends today? Oh, they're all on vacation. I get it. It's cool. Yeah. All right, so the first thing you're going to do when you meet up with somebody is what? We're going to come up with a game plan, people. Okay, you've got to have an action plan available. And if you don't really have an idea what you want, this is the way to find out. Meet with your true, real estate consultant. Get together with them. Go over what your goals are. Talk about how much you think you want to spend, how much you think, you know, obviously we can get it for less. That's the idea. Well, you know, get what you're looking for less. Although you might be able to get everything you're looking for and a bag of chips for just a little bit more.
Again, you're lying. You're giving out a bag of chips now.
Chips. Okay. We've got 2 cups of coffee.
Okay. I like that. A meal from Jack in the Box.
Boy, I guess I shouldn't have the coffee on an empty stomach, is my guess. Well, ladies and gentlemen.
Excuse us today.
It's all about the entertainment. Listen, when you're going through this process, you've got to have a sense of humor. We kid around back and forth, but you've got to have a sense of humor. This stuff is so serious, and it can be so vital to what you're doing. Take a breath and know that you're working with the right people so they can give you the right steps to go with and move forward into your purchase. So you're thinking about it. And listen, you got to get together with a true financial expert who's going to be able to show you what the proper loan is going to look like for you. You know, if your credit score is 520 and you don't have a job or a down payment, getting a home may be something to plan for. And you may be thinking, yeah, I know, that's me right now. Well, that's okay. But at some point, let's face it, the people who are getting money and have wealth and have long-term return from their investment, and those who have successful careers with their finances so they can retire, they all have real estate. So keep that in mind as a kind of a separation in this country and in the rest of the world. If they could go ahead and look at the big picture, those people who own property versus those who don't own.
Real estate is a must-have in your portfolio. I mean, you can have all sorts of assets, but real estate is a must-have. I don't know anybody who has ever built wealth without having real estate, without including real estate in their portfolio.
Absolutely. And you don't even need to have it be necessarily here. It doesn't have to be your prime residence or your primary residence, so to speak. It can be in other locations. Maybe there's a better location for you to buy in. Still, speak with someone here who wherever you're living so they can give you some advice about where they're seeing the trends in the market. We constantly are traveling. We travel outside of the area to know the markets all over the country, all over the world, so we can advise people left and right with exactly what's working for their portfolio.
So we can find better deals for you.
Yeah, you want a deal. So you need to know where to invest your money the best way and most effectively so you can get the best return on investment. What is that called? The ROI.
The ROI.
ROI,
return,
right?
On investment.
Yes.
Exactly. That is exactly right.
Yes. I see you sending that out in your emails to people all the time. Yes. And we consult with people. You know, for us, even today, we were having consultations around the world with our team so we can be sure to provide clients with the best opportunities. Listen, there are some places that are rock bottom right now that people who were buying here in LA 15 years ago are dying that they're not doing the same thing again now. So exactly. People are jumping on board for these things. So you want to make sure you've got your pre-approval ahead of time.
And real estate forever, it has shown, like, you know, in a 20, 30 year, it's always going up. Whether it's going a little or, you know, or a lot, it's always going, in the long term especially, it's always going up. Because we have never seen, like, you know, negative return on real estate in the long term.
Nope. And if you own it long enough.
Usually what? 5 to 8%?
Exactly. 5 to 8%. In LA, it's usually a little bit more.
A little bit more, yeah.
So you're usually seeing that. That means you're not going to get a better return in almost anything else. Stocks, even. Any financial planner, which we will be bringing on. We're going to have a special guest at the end of this month.
And the law says whatever was being repeated in the past, it will be repeated in the future, so.
Yes, not necessarily the law of the United States, but just the law.
The law.
The law in general.
The law in general. The law of statistics, probably.
Oh, that one's good too, yeah. I like that.
If something was being repeated in the past, it will be repeated in the future. That's like, yeah, just my thought.
It's accurate.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
Anyway, so yeah, first of all, get together with a real estate agent who can help you. You will ask him all your questions, and they will ask you.
Or she.
Or she, yeah. And they will ask you questions as well. I mean, we want to know.
They better be.
We want, exactly. I mean, we want to know things about you. It's not that we are nosy, but we have to know in order to better help you. And same thing applies to mortgage brokers as well. They will ask you questions. You ask your questions, they ask you questions. And, you know, it's not intimidating. It's normal.
Especially if it's your first time out. If this is your first time out buying a property of any kind, it may feel quite invasive that people are asking questions like this. The reality of asking the questions is because nobody wants to be on the other side of a poor choice for you. Nobody.
You should be skeptical if they don't ask you questions and they agree on everything you say.
Yes. Yes.
That's where
yes.
You should be skeptical.
Okay. Yes. Don't ask you any questions. What are you planning to do? How long do you plan to be there? What are your goals? Do you have children? Do you plan to have children? Are your kids moved out? Are you thinking to be single? Well, whatever your choice is, it's good to know so that your best investment is made available.
Right.
And get that pre-approval ahead of time because you don't want to be shopping for a house. Listen, how many times we have people call and say, great, I'm thinking about buying and I'd like to go shopping for houses. Listen, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. The best thing to do is get the pre-approval done first. It's like, as I have had my conversations with my lady friends,
mm-hmm.
Say, let's not go shopping for a bridal gown before you have a boyfriend. I'm just saying.
Exactly.
It's likely going to be more fun when you actually have knowledge that that could actually take place.
Uh-huh. And this is only going to help you because let's say a realtor agrees with the student, take you out without you having pre-approval. And you know what? The second home they show you is the home that you like, the home of your dreams. But you're not ready. You can't write an offer because you can't write an offer without a pre-approval. What are you going to do? And you lose the house the next 2 days. Somebody else who is pre-approved already and knows their financial situation and everything, everything is squared away with them, they write an offer and buy a house, and maybe with less than what you would offer.
That's correct.
What do you do then?
Going to be heartbroken.
Depressed.
Yes, and you'll be mad at the agent for showing you the property.
Exactly.
You know, the first time looking at a house, maybe. But listen, when you get serious and it's the second house, you've got to get that done. You know, it's tempting. It's, you know, it's just not going to help you in the long run.
And a good realtor should not take you out and start doing, you know, and start the process without you being pre-approved, because, you know, all this thing is emotional and is only going to hurt you. And we don't want to hurt our clients, so we don't do that.
We say no to hurt. No.
Exactly.
No.
We don't want to find you the house that you need, because we are going to find you the house that you
It's going to happen right away.
Yeah. Like, if it's not the first day out, it will be the second. Like, you know, we understand. We work with so many clients. We understand the psychology, what they're looking for.
If they're truly ready. Sorry.
Yeah. If they're truly ready. Exactly. You tell us 5 things, we understand 20. You know, that's how it is. So we know what you're looking for. We're going to find it for you. So that's why we only take out clients who are pre-approved.
And it's like eating your vegetables. You have to eat your vegetables. You know,
do your homework, of course.
So dessert is the house.
Mm-hmm.
That's the house or the home, wherever you're going to be.
It doesn't come first. It comes last.
That's what exactly. Right?
Exactly. Okay.
I love this job. You have no idea. It's all about the entertainment, people. All right. So then after you've gotten the pre-approval, what's going to happen next?
What's going to happen next?
What's your new nickname? What was your nickname yesterday?
Gosha.
Gosha.
That's my name in Russian, actually.
I love it already. Gosha.
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 Babushka.
Ah.
And what was the other? Piroshki.
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 Okay.
No, that's not the name. It's a food.
Wow. Okay.
But
glad you got it.
It's in this category. Gosha, babushka.
I know. Popa.
Piroshki. Popa?
Popa.
What's popa?
Mm.
Oh, okay. Another good word.
No, it's fine. It's not a bad word. Just a word. Just a word.
You're surprising me today because I've never heard you cursing, so I'm like...
No cursing? There's no cursing? I haven't cursed?
I'm kidding.
I haven't cursed. I swear to you.
Yes, never. I've never heard you saying F word.
I didn't say that either. I'm just saying today on the show, I have not cursed.
No.
After the show, I'm free to curse, though.
And before.
Okay. <Nuh-uh. laughs> So now you've been pre-approved. Okay, get on with the next step of what you want to have happen. Guess what that's going to be, everybody? You're going to get a look at houses. You're going to look at homes. Let's go check it out. Let's go see what's going on. We're going to take you through step by step what's available. Well, oftentimes, people will say, great, I would like to get a foreclosure. That's awesome. I wish you were here 5 years ago. That would have been the perfect time to start looking for a foreclosure. So those likely aren't going to be on the market. But it's good to know what is on the market. What can you expect? What do you see in the neighborhoods you're looking for? If you're looking in Venice, are you going to see a lot of homes that are renovated or not renovated? What's your price point? What is your need for the home? Do you need 3 bedrooms? Are you okay with doing a renovation? And when we say renovation, we mean from bottom to top. A complete renovation is like the house was left halfway done, the contractor took off, and you have all cash to pick up a property.
And be realistic, because some people say, oh, I can definitely take on, you know, a fixer-upper and paint it. You know, that's not a fixer-upper that, you know.
No.
So be realistic what you
can
do.
Be realistic. We love these conversations. So because it shows people who are driven and who are animated and excited about getting into a home. And we love that because it shows your initiative and the fact that you work 50 hours a week and that you're just newly married and that's your first time living together and that you want to buy a home where you're going to spend all of your cash to renovate it and you're going to live in it at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And did I mention you were just recently married?
Yes, you did.
Please don't do it. Please, do yourself a favor.
Right.
Buy yourself a house that's 90% of the way there, maybe 95% of the way there.
Don't pretend to be an investor, a builder, you know, 10 things together.
It's a great idea, but the reality of it is most of the times we have seen statistics prove that people who undergo that process inevitably end up not only strained, stressed, likely divorcing,
mm-hmm.
financially strapped, and furious at themselves for ever gone into right. such an adventure at their first step, especially with no experience in it.
Home buying might be, you know, the biggest purchase of your life, and you have to think about it, and you have to be realistic on your needs and wants and what you can actually do and can't do.
And keeping with your lifestyle, there may be a real opportunity for you to be understanding of the fact that you still like to go on vacation. What's wrong with that? Maybe you like to go out. Maybe you're going to go on vacation. That's fantastic. Maybe there's a balance that you spend less money on rent that doesn't give you any return whatsoever.
Builds you no equity.
And puts you at the mercy of a landlord. And the truth of the matter is you have nothing to help you with taxes when you're a renter. And you're hoping no one buys the building. You're hoping the rate doesn't go up. You're hoping they'll still fix the leaky faucet that they've been saying they're going to fix for the last 3 weeks. And you're still hoping that your neighbor is going to move out.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Anyway.
That's another topic of a different sort.
I'm sorry. I apologize. I digress. I'm back.
I'm kidding. Okay, so.
So you're going out to look at properties, get educated about the area. You know what's available. After you've gone out with your agent, they're going to show you this, this, and this. This is what you can expect.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's the biggest part. You want to know what to expect. That's why we've come up with this lovely flow chart.
Right.
Available for download off of glamestates.com.
This is a flowchart that we give out to all buyers, especially first-time home buyers. So we get any international buyers as well. So they get familiarized with the home process, home buying process. And, you know, people that are outside of the U.S. and they don't know, you know, that we have to write an offer, the contracts, the escrow, everything that goes on. And it's everything that's involved in a transaction. It's everything is in this magic piece of paper right here.
Everything you needed to know about the process and a bag of chips and 2 cups of coffee.
Oh, you didn't put anything extra in there.
Not this time.
Okay.
I'm waiting till the end.
Okay. I'm curious.
I'm glad you're paying attention.
What are you going to add?
Well, you just don't know yet, do you? What? Now it's a cheeseburger too? What if I don't eat meat?
Well, anyway. A feast taco.
Okay, as long as it's gluten-free, we're ready. Okay. Oh, and Gregory, you are fantastic at sending out our clients the daily hot sheets of what to expect, what's happening in their neighborhood. What do you tend to hear from people like on the street, and they ask you questions? The same thing that I know I hear all the time when I'm doing my stuff out there for clients. I hear people say stuff like, hey, I saw this property on... Now we're going to name brand again. Zillow or Trulia.
In an online source. You know,
somewhere online. On a website that's not from what we call an MLS. Listen, those are advertising sites, guys.
Yeah, let us tell you a couple of things about that.
Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. That's how you say.
Well, let me tell you something.
I said told you, but okay.
Go ahead.
No, it's your turn. Go ahead.
Oh, no, you started
it. No, you.
You started it, you finish it.
No.
All right. Yeah, so these websites are good. Sometimes they're helpful, but they don't have accurate information all the time.
Why is that?
Well, I'll tell you. I'll give you an example. Like this week, we received an email from someone who was looking to buy a home that was listed and sold, 3-4 years ago, like 2011 or 12, I think. And it showed
us. It's not the first time, yeah.
As active, yeah. And it's not just recently. That was like 2 days ago and was the most recent thing. And it was listed and sold, 2-3 years ago. And it showed active on these online websites. And they called us and they're like, I really love to see the house. Please tell me, are there offers? You know, what do you know? And I called this poor lady and I said, you know, this home was in the market and it's sold, you know, 2011
for half the value.
Yeah, exactly.
Of what it is today. Can you
imagine?
So,
what you're looking the same exact home now would be at least $300,000-$400,000 more, because of the location it is and all the market appreciation from 2011 and blah blah blah, and she got disappointed and you know. She didn't, you know, from what I understood, I don't know. I have to call back, but I don't think, you know, she got really disappointed.
Understandably so. Listen, those websites, they're advertising selling for the most part. For the most part. It's not all of it. But a lot of it is also available for the public to put up whatever they feel like. And sneaky agents who are...
putting up fake listings just to get phone calls.
It's true. All kinds of stuff is up there. And also, it's a little misleading. I'll say it's a lot misleading. Half the time, if you look on the site, you can see things that say what appears to be when they're showing a quote unquote value, which is not accurate anyway.
Their
version of a estimate is on there, which is they tell you themselves.
It's at least 30% off.
It's up or down. It could be anything. So please don't go by that. That's really not accurate.
And this is why?
Because it's an accurate number. It's an algorithm.
It includes sales. You know, it includes transactions that are like inside the family. And
not, I hope grandma doesn't sell the house to grandson to for grandson. The same price that she would sell it on the street to anybody that she'd never met. I hope not.
So they take all the numbers.
Interfamily transactions.
Interfamily transactions.
Divorces,
and stuff like that.
Sales.
And they make an average and they give you an estimate.
Refinances.
Including the grandson, grandmother transaction that was like, you know, 60% less of the home value. And then they give you a value based on that for your home.
And then it's the average in the neighborhood. And then it's just
completely
inaccurate.
And one follows
inaccurate.
The other and it's a complete disaster for the whole neighborhood. And you think, even if you're a seller, you think your home worth, you know, $1 million and it actually worth 1.3, 1.4. Or the opposite, you are a buyer and you think, you know, you can buy something for 900, but actually it doesn't exist any, you know, it's 1.3 or 1.4 again, you know?
Absolutely. It's difficult to know what you're going to get. So it's good you talk with someone.
Right.
And a lot of that information, so it'll appear as if that home is for sale, but it'll say things like off market. Yet that means it's not for sale, but they don't want to tell you that because they want to keep driving you back to the site. Naughty. Bad. We don't like that.
And all these websites are not real estate firms. So that's why they don't give, that's another reason they don't give accurate information. They don't update their stuff.
And they're being sued.
Yeah. They don't kind of have to, you know, and they're being sued for that because they're misleading people big time. So if you want to, if you're a seller, like if you're a homeowner and you want an estimate for your home, take a broker's opinion. Take an agent, you know, call an agent and ask for an agent's opinion, and he will take the comparables of the neighbor. He will
do
the work.
You always say the he.
They. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah, ladies.
Yeah. They will run the whole thing, you know, properly, not based on interfamily transactions that are not accurate.
Yes.
So
she.
She.
Can give you some great information. I'm just kidding.
Right.
All right. Well, and then what's the next step? So you found a place you like. Guys, don't hold back. Put out an offer.
Don't worry about it. Don't overthink it. You like it, put an offer.
It's
you like the one next to it, put an offer on that as well.
You can it's put it on 10, hurt. But do it with, use the same agent, please. Don't say to yourself, oh, I'm going to go with the listing agent. I'm only going to speak with the listing agent. A huge mistake for buyers.
Right.
Huge, huge, huge mistake.
That's another thing. You want your own representation. You don't want to be represented from somebody that already represents first somebody else. You want to be represented exclusively from an agent that is representing you. Not the seller side, because many people are going, oh, I'm going to write an offer with a listing agent. Well, guess what? The listing agent first represent the seller, the owner of the property, and then they represent you.
Yes. So you may know what your bottom line, your number is, but you're trying to negotiate. If you're trying to negotiate a price,
you come second.
How are you going to go ahead and give a price that's negotiated when the other side already knows what your best number is for them? There's no way to win from that. Plus the liability behind it. Do yourself a favor. It doesn't cost you any more. And the chances of you actually getting the offer accepted are higher because you're going to have an intellectual offer that is really bipartisan. It's for you, right? That's going to be represented to the seller. And guess what? If you're the one thinking, oh, I'm going to contact the listing agent and just work with the listing agent, you're not the only one. So okay. Now you're competing against yourself with other people. You gain nothing from it, and likely you will have much looser terms that you have to follow up with than the seller. Mm-hmm. So if you're not looking to negotiate, and if you're okay with paying more than you probably need to, for sure, or have terms or special conditions that you have to come up with, outstanding chance that's going to happen to you if you're represented by the listing agent and you're the buyer. So
exactly.
Be cautious, please, please.
So long story short.
Bring your own agent.
Yes.
For yourself. But make your offers. Don't hesitate. We have a full episode about this, right, Gregory?
Yeah, we had an episode.
You can look for it, download it.
Two or three episodes ago, I think.
You can download it. It's on iTunes. It's available on the websites. You can completely go through this one step at a time and know and understand what the offer is. So go for it. Review it. Check it out. It's not going to hurt you. It doesn't cost you anything to listen to it and go through and understand what you can expect.
Yeah, we talk extensively about offers, how to write it, the psychology behind an offer, how sellers perceive it, you know, how it will look good in an offer, what, you know, all that. Terms. Money, deposit, this, that, the other thing.
This guy's good.
And the other thing.
And a bag of chips, plus two cups of coffee.
What else?
Woo! And a cheeseburger, you said
and
last
a cheeseburger.
Time.
And
message in a bottle.
Uh-huh.
And a blue moon.
And a blue moon. Anyway.
That's right.
So let's say you write your offer or your offers. One of them is going to be accepted. Then we have the acceptance of contract.
That's right.
We have a lot of pieces of paper signed by the seller and the buyer.
How do you say mucho in the Greek?
Poles.
Poles.
Or poli. Poli for
poli.
Poli.
Poli. Poli. Which is a lot.
It's
mucho, poli.
Maybe you should have like what's that lady that does the you learn a new language? I should be, you know what I'm talking about?
No.
The lady that helps you learn languages. You were thinking of doing it to learn Greek or Chinese?
There's a lot of different ones out there.
No,
it's Russian.
A lady that's very famous. Who does that?
Okay.
You buy her program or you watch her online.
Is it a lady or is it a company?
No, it's a lady who owns a company. Anyway.
All right.
Yeah, it will come to me.
Got it. See, let's say you've got your offer out there. Let's say it gets accepted. Listen, the next steps are you can have counter offers going back and forth, meaning that you send out an offer. The seller says, okay, but change this thing and we'll take it. And then you say, yeah, but kind of need this to happen too if we're going to say yes to this. So you do this part back and forth.
And this is part of negotiation.
Absolutely. This is negotiation process. And even when you get into it and you have each side has said, yes, we're ready to go. Let's do this. Things happen. Maybe afterwards you do your due diligence, as they say,
mm-hmm.
which means you are going to grab your two cups of coffee,
mm-hmm.
your cheeseburger, and a blue moon.
Yeah.
And your message in a bottle, and you're going to go to the corner of where this home is at.
Mm-hmm.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, bring that. Go for a walk in the neighborhood. Check it out. Make sure you feel comfortable living there because this will be where you live.
Exactly. You know, take your family for a walk around the neighborhood. People are asking, is it a safe neighborhood? Is it nice? Is it, you know, we don't know. We can't say.
Yes, and take it with a grain of salt. Everyone's idea of safe is completely different. My idea of safe is completely different than anyone else's. I grew up in the valley when it was lots of gang territory and things taking place. And then I was in law enforcement. I have a completely different sense of safety versus anybody else's. Mine's different than what his is going to be.
Mm-hmm. I grew up in Athens. So
yeah, you know.
Who knows what happens there.
Yeah, we weren't going to go into that, right? Not on this episode.
Not on this episode.
We'll tell about that one later.
Okay, and then, because we only have about 10, 15 minutes, after the acceptance of the contract, meaning after the acceptance of the offer, where the offer is signed by
you're
both
parties.
You're
going to open escrow.
We open the escrow where we talk about it on a few episodes back
yes,
again.
Yes, absolutely.
And we are going to talk again because escrow is a big chapter in real estate.
Mm-hmm.
You open escrow, meaning both parties with their agents are coming together and meet the, you know, with a neutral party, which is called escrow, that handles the paperwork and the money and the transactions and puts everything together in one plate.
Absolutely. And you're going to get lots of documents, which will include things like reports you never even considered that were available, what some things we call a natural hazard report. Mm-hmm. That's going to tell you whether or not this home is in a fire zone or is it a earthquake zone, and what's something we call liquefaction. Well, Southern California is pretty much liquefaction, so you've been living there likely anyway the entire time.
And it doesn't really mean that it has to do with your specific home that you are about, that you're going to buy. It means that, you know,
in the area.
In the area, I mean, the whole Los Angeles, the whole California has earthquakes. You know, it's not, doesn't mean that, you know, under your home there is an earthquake center, you know.
It also says things like you will find that you cannot cut down a particular types of oak trees in California. There are protected trees.
Protected trees, yeah.
You can't mess with those. Squirrels, certain types of squirrels. There's a brown squirrel, and then there's the owl. There are certain animals.
I'm not going to say this.
How many owls are in the neighborhood? So listen, don't kill the squirrels and the owls and the trees, okay? Pretty good? Okay. That's just a general rule anyway. I don't know anyone who's really doing that, especially here on the Boulevard or, you know, on the other side in on Ventura Boulevard either. So I don't really know anyone who's doing that. But, hey, it's good to know. Now you know. You've been told.
There.
You knew that anyway. It's fine. Be reasonable. Oh, and when you do your inspections.
Yes.
Gregory, when I do an inspection on a house, can I tear the wall down and, like, look inside and pull the roof off?
No. Thank God to the technology and the people we work with. Mm. They can do that without tearing the walls down. They
Beautiful.
Can look inside the walls without having to tear them down. How cool is that?
That is really cool stuff. That's great. So you'll get to know what's going on in the home. Listen, that's part of the experience. After you have acceptance, escrow will open. You'll have these time frames to get things completed. You'll have time frame to get your appraisal done. The appraisal on the property will be instigated through your lender. If you're buying cash, then you probably aren't going to get an appraisal anyway, because it's really, you already know how much it's worth to you. So that's all that matters.
And the way we write the offer is we make sure, first of all, that our clients are going to have the time they need to do their due diligence.
Right. Due diligence.
We're not harassing anybody, and we protect them. That's our principles. And educate them.
Do it again.
And advise them.
Yes.
And entertain them.
Yes.
And we take them we take them out to dinner.
Dun, 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 dun. You don't know that song?
No.
All right. It's fine.
Anyway. Okay. So, yeah.
Oh, don't forget about title insurance. Why do we need title insurance?
For many reasons.
Yes, including, and not limited to, knowing if the person who's selling you the property is actually the person legally able to sell you that property.
Chain of title.
Uh-huh. We like this. In other countries, we call this the notary, really.
Notary, yeah. That's how it is in Europe.
Completely different than notary here in the U.S. Mm-hmm. Completely. But basically, that's the title, the chain of title. And the title report that you will get says, yeah, there's somebody who's owed money for this property. And guess what? Before you can close the deal anyway, that's got to get paid off. And that's probably going to be the seller. On occasion, it has come up in the past years back when it was the buyer who had to pay the difference. But they knew that up front, walking into it, that, say, the homeowners association hasn't been paid for a year or two. But that was when properties were, you know, in the middle of foreclosure crisis. So you know that ahead of time. Everything gets told to you. But don't worry. During this process, you should have great communication with your agent. They should be available for you. They should be in contact with you. Take them out to dinner for coffee or cheeseburgers.
Or a bag of chips.
Oh, and a bag of chips. Dang it.
Because
we're going to have a healthier episode next week.
Feel that,
you understand
sometimes.
Me? Next week is a completely healthier episode.
For broccoli. We take them out for broccoli and kale and kale salad.
Oh, yes. That sounds good, actually. Okay. That sounds good. I like that. And you move on through. You're going to go through your homeowner's insurance. You'll have an opportunity to get your loan processed and finished. Listen, if you guys need more time to get things completed, be in communication with your agent. Whatever you do, do not fall out of communication with your agent, and your agent should not fall out of communication with you. They should be available virtually on the, you know, maybe in real life too, but holding your hand should be a virtual version of holding your hand. Mm-hmm. But holding your hand in real life may actually happen. That has happened on occasion when things go crazy. It's okay. We're here for you. That's what we do. We make sure that you're protected through the process.
Right.
Yeah. What do you think of that?
Is one of, the, of your questions that you should ask your when you hire an agent, the availability.
Yeah.
Availability is very important.
That's very accurate. You want to be able to get a hold of people.
That's why we are two in the price of one. And
that's right, sir.
With the whole team
a
behind
male,
us.
A male, a female, you know, got different approaches to things, works together.
17 languages, 17 translators.
That's 19. Don't forget.
19, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
What did we add?
I think it was Bulgarian.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Transaction coordinator.
Or let's go through the languages just real fast.
Okay.
We've got Bulgarian. English, I believe, but I'm not sure.
Do we have English?
No.
We should add
English,
this
Spanish,
one.
Greek. No.
Greek.
Yeah. Armenian.
Armenian.
Russian.
French.
French. I'm listening.
Bulgarian.
Bulgarian.
Chinese.
Chinese, absolutely. Arabic.
Both Chinese we have, right?
Absolutely.
The Mandarin,
so that's two,
and
three. Yeah. I know, now I can't count anymore, but go ahead, continue. We have Portuguese.
Uh-huh.
And we have Georgian. And we have Ukrainian.
Ukrainian, yes.
Uh-huh. And there are others that I'm missing the ballpark on right here. Dutch. Okay.
British English we have.
German.
We have British English. Canadian
LA.
English.
Canadian. We have LA. Lala.
We have Nevada English. I'm just kidding.
We have Southern.
Yeah, we're expanding to Nevada and all these states. So.
Yeah, Nevada. Oh, wait till you're here and see the... Oh, we have such great footage for that. Okay.
Okay, we have five more minutes.
Okay, so on to Lipwes, as they say. How do you say hurry up?
Grigora. It's like my name.
Grigora.
Is pame.
You'll be fluent in at least three languages by the time this is done.
What's this lady's name?
Where is Zhao Zhao, by the way? Where is our Zhao Zhao?
Exactly.
Where is she?
I don't know. We should contact
Sophie!
Her.
Sophie! Zhao Zhao. Monteith, where are you?
Ni hao. Ni hao.
Yeah! Where are you? Shout out for Sophie. Sophie.
Then... After the homeowner's insurance and all that, you know, everything goes well so far. The escrow, all the parties are satisfied.
Get to the exciting part. Don't forget to set up your utilities, for crying out loud, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget to set up your utilities. Change your address with the Postal Service. Don't just tell your neighbors. Please.
Right.
Set it up. Set it up. Costs $1 online with the USPS.
Dollar
Don't forget to send it in.
Something.
I lied. It was $1.47. Yeah. That's true. Plus, if it's postage too, you have to. Okay, so for less than $2, you can get your things delivered, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So it lasts for 6 months. Don't forget, ask your agent even to send out postcards to your neighborhood to say hi to everybody. Like, hey, this is new to the neighborhood. Not everybody wants that. Maybe you do. And they can. What we do is we also send out postcards too and notes to their friends to let them know you've moved. So you've moved. Everybody should know. Final walkthrough. So you're going to go through the house and make sure that it still looks relatively familiar to how you were purchasing it.
Walls are still there. The floor is there.
I know.
The roof is there.
You know, they didn't take down the chandelier that you wanted. And maybe if they did, we can get it, you know, all squared away. Sometimes people just have a complete misunderstanding of what they thought they could and couldn't take. It happens.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody keep a calm, cool, collected idea in their mind. You just keep going. Not to worry. That's what we're here for.
Mm-hmm.
That's what agents do. Great agents take care of you the whole step.
That's what agents, all the agents should do. Yeah. Anyway.
Correct.
Then,
I stand corrected. You're absolutely on target, sir. Then what happens?
Then after that, deposit the balance amount.
If you have a loan, deposit. You're going to hear from escrow. Is going to tell you, okay, it's 3 days before you're finishing. That means we're supposed to complete your transaction by the 31st. Let's pretend it's all during the week. Let's pretend. So let's say Monday, they say to you, okay, great. You need to sign your paperwork so that we can put your money in the bank. From the bank, and everybody says it's okay to what they say. Fund the loan on Tuesday.
Sign papers
on Monday. That gets quote-unquote funded Tuesday.
Uh-huh.
It should technically record the following day. It should. Doesn't always happen. That's the way it should.
Mm-hmm.
Then what happens on that day?
Then the escrow closes. And
then what?
You get the keys.
Yay! You're home. It's time to go home. Get your keys.
It's
woo-hoo!
Yours.
Woohoo! We close escrow.
After you do all this,
ka-ka-ka-ka.
About 30 to 45 days.
Eh.
It's going to be 45
yeah.
from...
Yeah.
When? October?
Yeah.
It's going to be 45 for all, but anyway.
We'll get to that.
Now it's about 30 days. If you go with a different loan, you know, non-conventional loan might be 45, but from October it's going to be 45 for everybody no matter what.
Anyway. It's all good. You'll be hilariously entertained through the process. You'll feel happy and chipper. Many people get stressed out during this process. Our clients really don't, though. They're pretty darn happy through it. Of course, the comedy hour.
Well, it's all about, you know, education, early education. If we tell them what to expect, then they know what to expect, you know, and they
take the stressors out.
Exactly.
Take it all away. Speaking of home, that brings us home. If you've closed and you've got keys, that brings us home today.
It's yours.
Absolutely. So that's kind of the process, kiddos. You can contact us online. You can call us. You can call us anytime at 562-537-2595.
That was me. And correcto. You can contact Coco at 323-425-9484.
That's true.
Call,
you
text,
can.
Call, text, send a message in a bottle, send a
smoke signal.
Smoke signal. All right.
Not that we have any comment about that whatsoever. Oh, contact us, please. Ask us why we're saying that.
Exactly.
And then, of course, there's the pigeon. Please ask us why we're making these comments.
You so can find our work on YouTube or on our Facebook page and website, glamestates.com. And have fun and enjoy.
Wait, don't forget about, you can also reach us on Instagram. Hey, find us on Instagram. It's
Instagram
fun.
Is fun. Yeah.
I like Instagram. There's some pictures of what? What's on Instagram this week? Shh.
Later.
Okay, so don't forget, those of you who are involved, don't forget you get your two cups of coffee, your cheeseburger, your bag of chips, and
the pop coffee. How do you say that? Coffee pop?
Oh, yes. I think it's called a cake pop, but it's good. Ladies and gentlemen, please reach out to us. We're here for you for all of your real estate information and needs. Let's get together and chat it up. Glam it up,
glam
baby.
Glam it up, baby.
Woohoo!
You're listening to Glam Estates Radio with your hosts, Coco and Gregory, right here on LA Talk Radio.